Hi and hello my dear students, welcome to my channel Max Tutor Vanmati. This video is based on class 10th new syllabus. No more fear for exam by following my videos. Today in 10th Max we are going to see the unit 2, in that example 2.21. The question is, the general term of a sequence is defined as an equal to n into n plus 3, where n belongs to natural numbers when it is odd, and again next an equal to n square plus 1 and when here n is even. Find the 11th and 18th terms. Okay, they have given the general term an is equal to n into n plus 1 when n is odd and n square plus 1 when n is even. We are going to find the 11th and 18th term. Okay, so first we can find 11th term. A 11, okay, A n, in the place of n substitute 11 when n is odd. Okay, you get A n equal to n into n plus 3. This is your given format, that is your general term. Okay, in that substitute A 11, in the place of n substitute 11, you will get 11 into 11 plus 3, which is equal to 11 into 11 plus 3 is your 14. 11 into 14, your answer is 154. Okay, this is your 11th term, A11. Clear? 11. Next, we are going to find 18th term. Okay, n is equal to 18. 18 is a even number. So, we are taking this condition. An equal to n square plus 1. So, from this, n is equal to 18. A18 equal to 18 square plus 1. Okay, so A18 equal to 325. Okay, 18 square you will get 324. 324 plus 1, 325. Clear? This is your 18th term. So from this, what we have found? A11, what we have found? A11 is your 154 and A18 is your 325. These were the final solution of example 2.21. Next we can see example 2.22. Next is your example 2.22. Find the first 5 terms of the following sequence. A1 equal to 1, A2 equal to 2, An equal to An minus 1 divided by An minus 2 plus 3. Where n is greater than or equal to 3. And n belongs to n, that is your natural numbers. Okay, so here we are going to find the first 5 terms of this following sequence. Already they have given the first term and second term. So now we are going to find the third term, fourth term and fifth term. These are the first 5 terms. Okay, given is a1 equal to 1, a2 equal to 1. Now we are going to find a3. So substituting an equal to 3 in the place of an, you will get A3 minus 1 divided by A3 minus 2 plus 3, because An minus 1, so n equal to 3, 3 minus 1, n minus 2 is here, 3 minus 2 plus 3. You will get A3 minus 2 is here, 3 minus 1 is here 2, and again A3 minus 2 is here A1 plus 3. What is your A2? A2 and A1 are 1. So 1 divided by 1 plus 3. You will get 1 divided by 4. This is your A3. Okay. Next we are going to find the A4. Similarly, substitute in this formula. A4 minus 1 divided by A4 minus 2 plus 3. You get A4 minus 3 is your A3. And A4 minus 2 is your A2 plus 3. A3, what is your value? 1 by 4 divided by A2 value is 1 plus 3, you will get 4. So from this you can write A3 is equal to 1 by, A4 equal to 1 by 4 into 1 by 4. Here 1 by 4 is there and again 1 by 4 is there. So I am writing as 1 by 4 into 1 by 4, you will get 1 by 16. So A3 is here 1 by 4, A4 is here 1 by 16. Okay, next we are going to find A5. Now we are going to find A5. I have written the previous values. A1 equal to 1, A2 equal to 1, A3 what we have found is 1 by 4. A4 again we have found 1 by 16. Now we are going to find A5. In the substituting in the place of N, 5. So you get A5 minus 1 divided by A5 minus 2 plus 3. So you get A5 minus 1 is your 4 and again 5 minus 2 is your 3 plus 3. A4 what you have got? 1 by 16 whole divided by A3, 1 by 4 plus 3. Okay, on simplifying this what you will get? 1 by 16 into 4 by 13 you will get. Okay, 1 by 4 plus 3 can be written as 1 by 4 plus 3 you will get. 4 3s are 12, 12 plus 1, 13 you will get 13 by 4. Okay, that I have here you will get 13 by 4. Taking reciprocal you will get 4 by 13. Okay, solving this you will get 4 4s are 16. Therefore A5 value is your 1 by 4 into 13. 4 3s are 12, 1 4 1s are 4 plus 1, 5. A5 is your 1 by 52. So A1, A2 they have given. Now we have found A3 value, A4 value and A5 value. Okay. Next we can see the exercise problems. Next exercise 2.4 second problem. Find the first four terms of the sequence whose nth terms are given by three subdivisions. First one, an equal to n cube minus 2. Second subdivision, an equal to minus 1 whole power n plus 1, n into n plus 1. And third subdivision is your an equal to 2n square minus 6. So in this three subdivisions, we are going to find the first four terms of the sequences. That is your n is equal to 1, 2, 3 and 4. Four terms we are going to find. First we can solve the first subdivision. Given general term is an equal to n cube minus 2. So substituting n is equal to 1, you get a1 equal to 1 cube minus 2. 1 cube is your 1, 1 minus 2 you will get minus 1. Next n is equal to 2 implies a2 equal to 2 cube minus 2. 2 cube is your 2 into 2 into 2. 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8. 8 minus 2 you will get 6. And again n is equal to 3, a3 is equal to 3 cube minus 2 which is equal to 3 cube, 3 3s are 9, 3s are 27. 27 minus 2 you will get 25. Next n is equal to 4, a4 equal to 4 cube minus 2. 4 4s are 16, 16 4s are 64 minus 2 you will get 62. So your values are a1 is equal to minus 1, a2 equal to 6, a3 equal to 25 and a4 equal to 62. These are the first four terms of the subdivision 1. Second subdivision, an equal to minus 1 whole power n plus 1, n into n plus 1. So again we are giving n equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 values. So first n is equal to 1 you will get an equal to minus 1, 1 plus 1, 1 into 1 plus 1. You will get minus 1 whole square, you will get minus into minus, you will get the answer in plus. So no need to write the plus. If you are getting in minus you can write, if you are getting in plus no need to write. So 1 into 1 plus 1, 1 plus 1 is your 2, 2 ones are 2. So a1 is equal to 2. Next, n is equal to 2. A2 equal to minus 1 whole power 2 plus 1, 2 into 2 plus 1, which is equal to A2 equal to minus 2 whole power 2 plus 1 is your 3. You're getting in odd power, then you'll get the answer in negative minus 2 into 2 plus 1. 2 plus 1 is your 3, 3 2s are 6. So A2 is equal to minus 6. Next, n is equal to 3. A3 equal to minus 1 whole power 3 plus 1, 3 into 3 plus 1. So minus 1 whole power 3 plus 1 is your 4. You are getting the odd power, even power. So your answer will be in positive only, no need to put plus. 3 into 3 plus 1, 3 plus 1 is your 4, 4 3s are 12. So A3 is equal to 12. Next is your n is equal to 4, which implies A4 equal to minus 1 whole power 4 plus 1, 4 into 4 plus 1, which implies A4 equal to minus 1 whole power 5. You are getting it is in odd power, so you'll get the answer in negative minus, you'll get in minus. So 4 into 4 plus 1, 4 plus 1 is your 5, 5 4s are 20, A4 is your minus 20. These are the values of A1, A2, A3 and A4. And one more third subdivision is there. Third subdivision is equal to An equal to 2n square minus 6. By using this method, you try this as homework. Next problem. Next exercise 2.4, fourth problem. Find the indicated terms of the sequences whose nth terms are given by. Here they are given the general term an equal to 5n by n plus 2. So now we are going to find the a6 and a13. These were the indicated terms in the question, a6 and a13. So we are going to use this general term to find a6 and a13 term. First we can find a6, that is n is equal to 6. Put n is equal to 6 in the place of the general term n. So a6 equal to 5 into 6 divided by 6 plus 2. You will get 5, 6 are 30 divided by 6 plus 2 is your 8. Solving this you will get 2, 15s are 30, 2, 4s are 8. So a is, which implies a6 equal to 15 divided by 4. Okay, next n equal to 13. We are going to find a13 value. So 5 into 13 divided by 13 plus 2. 5 3s are 15, 1, 5 1s are 5 plus 1, 6. 65 divided by 15. On solving this, you will get 5 13s are 65, 5 3s are 15. Which implies A13 is equal to 13 divided by 3. So these were the A6 and A13 values. Next we are going to find the second subdivision in the same problem. Exercise 2.4, fourth problem, second subdivision. An equal to minus of n square minus 4. We are going to find A4 and A11. Okay, using this we are going to find A4 and A11. First, n is equal to 4. You will get A4 equal to, substituting n equal to 4 in this term, you will get minus of 4 square minus 4. You will get minus of 4 square is your 16 minus 4, which implies minus 16 minus 4 is your 12. So you will get minus 12. This is your A4 value. A4 equal to minus 12. Next, what we have to find? A11. So n is equal to 11, you will get A11 equal to minus of 11 square minus 4. Minus of 11 square is your 121 minus 4. You will get minus 117. Clear? This is your A11. These were the A4 and A11 answers. Next, we can find fifth problem. Example 2.4, fifth problem. Find A8 and A15 whose nth term is given as An equal to n square minus 1 by n plus 3 when n is even, and An equal to n square by 2n plus 1 when n is odd. Okay, they have given two general terms, even and odd, and we are going to find A8 and A15. Here A8 is your, n is equal to 8 and 8 is your even number, so we are taking this even condition. And A15, n equal to 15, 15 is your odd number, so we are taking the odd condition. Clear? Okay, next we can solve now. So substituting n equal to 8 in this equation, in this general term, you will get a square, 8 square minus 1 by 8 plus 3. You get 8 square is your 64, 8 8s are 64, minus 1 divided by 8 plus 3 is your 11. Okay, from this we can write A 8 is equal to 63 divided by 11. Clear? And again, coming to the second one, A 15, N equal to 15, substituting in the place of N 15, you will get 15 square divided by 2 into 15 plus 1. You will get 15 square is here, 225 divided by 215s are 30, 30 plus 1, which implies you get A 15 equal to 225 divided by 31. This is your A 15. Clear? Understood? Next we can move on to the sixth problem. Exercise 2.4, sixth problem. This is your last problems of the section. If A 1 equal to 1, A 2 equal to 1 and A n equal to 2a n minus 1 plus a n minus 2, where n is greater than or equal to 3 and n is a natural number, then find the first 6 terms of the sequence. Okay, already we have seen the example 2.22, same like this only. They have given a1, a2 and they are asked to find first 5 terms of the sequence. Here they have asked to find first 6 terms of the sequence, and here they have given the general term as a n equal to 2a n minus 1 plus a n minus 2. Clear? This is your sequence. From this we are going to find the first 6 terms. Okay? So already they have given a1 equal to 1 and a2 equal to 1. Okay? Next we are going to find n equal to 3, 4, 5, 6. We are going to find these 4 sequence, these 4 terms. Okay? First n equal to 3. Substituting n equal to 3 here, you will get a3 equal to 2a 3 minus 1 plus a 3 minus 2. Clear? You will get a3 equal to 2a 3 minus 1 is your 2 and again 3 minus 2 is your 1. From this, you can substitute 2 into a1, a2 value is your 1, a1 value is your 1. So from this you will get 2 ones are 2, 2 plus 1, 3. Okay. So your A3 is nothing but 3. Clear? Next we can find N is equal to 4. A4 equal to 2A 4 minus 1 plus A 4 minus 2. You will get A4 equal to 2A 3. 4 minus 1 is your 3. 4 minus A 4 minus 2 is your 2. Okay. So A 4 equal to 2 into A 3 value is your 3 and A 2 value is your 1. From this you will get 2 3s are 6. 6 plus 1 is your 7. This is your A 4. Clear? Next we can see A 5 and A 6. Okay. Already we have found, given A1 equal to 1, A2 equal to 1 and we have found A3 equal to 4, A4 equal to 7. Next we are going to find A5. A5, substituting in the place of N, you will get, replacing 5, you will get 2A 5 minus 1 plus A 5 minus 2. Then you will get A5 equal to 2A 5 minus 1 is your 4 and 5 minus 2 is your 3, which implies A5 equal to 2 into A4 value is your 7, A3 value is your 3, which implies A5 you will get 2 7s are 14, 14 plus 3, 17. This is your A5 value, fifth term. Next we are going to find the sixth term. A6 equal to 2A 6 minus 1 plus A 6 minus 2. A6 equal to 2A 6 minus 1 is your 5 and 6 minus 2 is your 4. And again A6 equal to 2 into A5 value is your 17 plus and A4 value is your 7. You will get A6 equal to 2 7s are 14, 1, 2 1s are 2 plus 1, 3, 34 plus 7. You will get A6 equal to 41. Clear? Okay. These were the first 6 terms of the sequence. A1 equal to 1. A2 equal to 1. A3 equal to 3. A4 equal to 7, A5 equal to 17 and A6 equal to 41. Up to this, exercise 2.4 is over. Okay, from next video, we can see the arithmetic progression. I hope you all clear about today's video. Feel free to comment your doubts or just mail your doubts to me. Okay, I am there for you to rectify your doubts. If you like my channel, then subscribe my channel for more videos. Thank you. Meet you soon in next video.